Look, I'm sorry for leaving you there like that. How'd you get home?
I drove your car. I hear music. What's going on?
I'm doing a reshoot. The client couldn't wait.
Must have been life or death.
The client thinks so. I'm just pushing it through.
Well, don't rush. You want to get it right this time.
Look, I'm going to be done here in a couple hours. Maybe we can still have a late dinner.
Not tonight. I'm sure you and Paulina will be much too busy.
Paulina.
Caroline told me you left with her at the gallery.
Caroline did.
And you didn't.
You're mad.
I have to go.
Molly, wait.
Someone's at the
door. We'll talk tomorrow.
Too stunned to speak?
What?
Good. That's a start. I was thinking you'd never talk to me again.
You are unbelievable.
I was hoping you'd think so.
Damn it, Vicky. How far were you planning on taking this?
Vicky?
You think I didn't know? What the hell kind of game do you think you're playing?
Are you sure you have the right house?
I asked myself that before I knocked.
And?
I was wondering if this is a mistake.
Oh, it's okay. We all make mistakes.
Good. I'm glad you feel that way, because I think we can get by this.
What do you think you're doing?
Inviting myself in.
Why?
Well, I had to, because you didn't. I was going to stand outside all day. Your manners are lousy.
Too bad. Get out.
Not until we settle a few things.
Settle what things? I'm going to call the police.
What's best for you? I am the police, remember?
Oh, of course. I just... I didn't remember because you weren't in uniform.
Uh-huh.
It's okay. Take whatever you want.
I usually do.
Please, just leave me alone.
Well, you know, you send out some real mixed messages, you know that?
Clear. Don't you come near me.
Come on, Vicky. It's a little extreme even for you, don't you think?
Vicky. Of course, I should have known.
Known what? Oh. What's so funny? You are the most confusing woman I've ever met.
Well, at least I know why you're confused. I'm not Vicky.
You're...
Oh, boy.
Oh, she said she had a sister. She didn't tell me you two look exactly alike.
I'm Marley. You must be Ryan, the hero on horseback.
Ryan Harrison. She told you about me?
A little.
Oh. Well, where is she now?
With Vicky, I'm sure it's someplace interesting. Let's go.
This is a new low even for you, Vicky.
It took you long enough to figure it out.
Oh, I caught on. I was just trying to drive you crazy, which is exactly what you deserve.
What do you deserve, my sister?
I know you don't care how you treat me. But how could you do this to your own sister?
Oh, honey, I was just returning the favor. See, Marley and I have more in common than just our bodies.
Look, you and Marley are nothing alike.
Really? Or do we just kiss differently?
You know, I was really starting to believe all the stuff you were saying about the changed you.
I don't like being lied to.
Nobody lied to you.
You and Marley have both lied to me since you've been back from France.
You're wrong.
Jamie, don't you think I deserve to know this?
Vicky, what do you call this little stunt of yours? You call that
honesty? I call it the only way to find out what's been going on between my sister and you.
We have both told you it was nothing. This is a complete invasion of Marley's privacy.
I deserve to know if my sister's going after my husband.
She is not. And I am not your husband anymore. And this is a perfect example why.
If nothing was going on, then why were you sighing when you were talking about that night at the inn in France?
Vicky, there are things in this world that you will never understand, no matter who tries to explain.
Oh, honey, I understand this perfectly. You were in France. You were alone. And you were lonely.
So
and as much as you tried to deny it, you were missing me.
You know, you are crazy.
Really? What was so different about Marley this time? God, Jamie, you've known her for years. You never made a move on her before.
I really didn't know Marley before.
You had me before.
You know, you are totally confused here. You're losing it.
No, I'm not. You went out of your way to spend time with a little different version of me. You haven't gotten over me, Jamie.
Vicky said that you were very interesting.
I guess that means I didn't get raves, huh?
Oh, I think she was impressed with how you rode a horse, but, how should I put this? Nobody likes being held over a balcony.
Yeah, I guess I got a little carried away.
Are you really a cop?
Badge and everything.
Well, you know, people get arrested for holding other people over edges of balconies.
You're right, you're right. And I was dead wrong. You're a good sister.
Oh, I try to be.
I must admit, though, Vicky does bring out the, irrational in me.
I can relate to that.
Yeah. Well, do you know when she's going to be back?
With Vicky? You never know.
Because I'd like to hang out if I could. I wanted to settle an argument we've been having. Rationally.
That seems like a worthy mission. Good luck. Can we get you a soda?
Yeah, thanks.
Okay.
Listen, I'm really sorry I barged in like that. Scared you half to death.
Apology accepted.
It's funny.
What is?
You. And you look just like her, but you're definitely the kinder, gentler sister.
Oh, don't be so quick to make that assumption.
And why not? Well, let me tell you something. The first impression you get of Vicky is one more of hellcat than lady.
Well, that's just because you don't know her very well.
Uh-huh.
She's actually a very gentle, loving person.
Really? Well, tell me more.
Only you would think that what happened to two other people was really about you.
I thought you said nothing happened.
You're impossible.
Now, if Marley and I are so different, how come you couldn't tell it was me tonight?
I did know.
You didn't know until you kissed me.
No one kisses like you, Vicky.
Not even Marley.
Stop trying to trap me.
I'll stop when you tell me about Nice.
Fine. It was strange when I first saw Marley. Of course I thought about you.
I knew it.
But then I spent a little time with her. And I realized that Marley was a lot of things that you aren't.
Like what?
Like moral, considerate, patient, totally honest.
How about loyal?
That too.
Well, by golly, she's a regular Eagle Scout.
I have to go.
Oh, Matt, we were just getting to the good part.
Oh, I'm sorry, this is important. We found a tissue match for a guy who needs a transplant. I have to go to St. Louis.
Jamie. Don't make me the bad guy in this.
You do that for yourself, Vicky. I told you. Marley and I were friends and niece. End of story. And the reason that it's not going to go any further is because Marley would never want to hurt you. I wonder if she'll feel the same way when she hears about this.
Thanks. She's your sister. You should know. The way you describe her, I've never met that side of her.
Oh, well, Vicky likes to put her worst foot forward. Someone we know says that she dares people to love her.
Well, why does she want to be so tough?
Wasn't her choice, exactly. Oh, she didn't grow up here with me.
Why not?
We were separated when we were born.
Sounds like a plot from Shakespeare.
Well, this was no comedy. Vicky grew up in a town called Lassiter.
She mentioned something about that. She called it a pit.
A pit. Well, she spent most of her life there trying to get out or just survive, and it made her kind of single-minded.
Some people call that selfish.
Yeah, some people do. Vicky just spent most of her time on her own. She didn't think much about how what she did affected other people.
Impulsive, right?
No, extremely, and stubborn and aggressive, blunt.
You know, it's funny, when you use those words to describe her, they really don't sound that negative.
Frankly, there are times I wish I could be more like her.
Well, she could stand to be a little more like you, too.
Thank you. But Vicky is pretty much her own person.
Yeah. And sometimes some of the things she does seem to make sense only to her.
And end up hurting her the most.
Yeah, I know the feeling.
Well, it sounds like you two have something in common.
Yeah, we're both the black sheep of the family.
Oh.
Yeah, well, I really got to get going.
Well, don't fear, you have to.
No, you've been great, but I really don't think I can hang around here all night.
Okay.
So, could you tell her I stopped by?
Oh, of course I will.
And try not to make me sound too much like a maniac.
Okay, I won't.
Good night.
Good night.
are you doing home? Did Jake dump you again?
He had an emergency at the studio.
Oh. Seems to be having a lot of those lately.
Where have you been?
Out. Good night.
Oh, Vicky, friend.
Why are you wearing that?
I thought you hated that outfit. You always told me I looked like an ex-nun.
Oh, well, hope you don't mind. It looked,
You never borrow my clothes. And you never wear your hair like that either.
Didn't have time for anything else.
You were trying to look like me, weren't you? Why would you do that?
What have we here? Happy memories with my husband?
Been to see Jamie, haven't you?
I'm sure he'll tell you all about it. Don't you walk out of this room! You dress up like me, you pretend to be me, I want an explanation!
You're smart. You figure it out. You're not even ashamed of yourself, are you?
I do what I have to do.
It's not always pretty, but it works. You pretended to be me. Now, what exactly did you do?
Don't worry. Nothing happened. Jamie and I just talked.
That sounds familiar.
Couldn't leave things alone, could you?
I had to find out what happened. What you were
about
hiding.
What?
You certainly weren't going to tell me. Well, about France, for one. Would you stop harping on France?
Who's harping? Jamie's the one who remembers all the wonderful, sappy memories.
You're so bitter about this.
It is not my fault that Jamie didn't take you with him.
And it is not my fault that you were making hay while the moon shines.
I did not.
Translating for him? Being friendly, but not too friendly. Showing him your perfect self.
Marley, love. Everybody's dream goddess.
Will you stop it?
Oh, I wish I could.
It makes me sick just to think about it. There's nothing Jamie loves more than a challenge.
You provided that for him, didn't you? Huh? How far did you go?
A couple passionate kisses? In that sweet little country inn?
Hand-holding under the moonlight?
This is what you think about.
You knew just when to end it, didn't you? When he wanted to take you to bed with him.
Why do you twist everything around?
I am not trying to take Jamie away from you.
Just like you didn't try to take Jake away from me.
Why don't you find your own men?
I still don't see how you do it. How you drive people away. Well, at least you're there to always pick up the pieces.
It's you, Vicky. You push people away. You do it to yourself. It's not me. I thought I could trust you. This is how you demonstrate your trust. You don't trust anyone, Vicky. That's your problem. Not even the people who love you the most.
Oh, God, like who?
Like you and Jamie? Give me a break.
You should both be grateful to me for what I've done.
This ought to be good.
Oh, it is. Jamie may like to think that he's fallen for the good sister and ditched the evil twin. But it's all the same to him.
You put us in the same dress and he can't even tell the difference.
How does that make you feel, honey?
He couldn't even tell us apart.
You two may like to think that you've got some secret romance going. But Jamie didn't fall for you.
He just fell for a different version of me.
I need to see Marley. Alone.
What happened to your medical emergency? Or is Marley more important than saving a life?
I was going to call you from the airport, Marley. But I had a few minutes. I thought that I would...
It's okay, I know what happened. I was here when Vicky got home.
I'm sorry, Marley. I wanted to tell you myself.
Well, why don't you? We would love to hear your version. I'm sure it's just absolutely...
Get out of my clothes now, Vicky. And leave us alone. I've had enough of you. Fine.
That's all that you can say.
What do you want me to say? Make yourself at home. Marley can do that. She's taken over my house like she's taken over everything else in my life. You haven't heard a word that I've said, have you, Vicky? You just want to think your own twisted thoughts. You know I'm right.
Don't worry. I won't be here when you get back.
I am sorry, Marley. I tried to explain to Vicky how it was in France.
And how did you do that?
Not too well, obviously. I tried to tell her that we were just friends, that it was just a casual thing.
She didn't believe you?
Vicky believes what she wants to believe. What did she say to you?
It's you.
Me?
I thought you knew me, Jamie. But I was wrong, wasn't I?
Well, I never thought I'd find you here.
What's the matter? No kidnappings tonight?
Well, I came by to see you earlier tonight.
Lucky for me, I wasn't there.
I met your sister.
Goody, goody for you.
At first, I thought she was you.
But then I guess. You realized how charming and delicate she was, and you were astonished that she was related to me, let alone my twin.
Well, she is sweet.
Just your type, right?
Might be fun, for a change.
Everyone wants to coddle sweet, angelic Marley.
Well, she seems very gentle and understanding.
Shouldn't she be? She was raised with silver spoons in her mouth. She was loved and pampered and spoiled.
Well, she was very nice about you.
She didn't stare into a gutter her childhood, wondering why nobody wanted her.
Is that what it was like in Lassiter?
She talked to you about Lassiter?
In passing, yeah.
What else did she talk to you about?
Well, she says that you have a soft side that you hide from the world.
What?
That's what she says.
Well, she's wrong.
Well, am I ever going to get to see it? You know, she's not as vindictive about you as you are about her.
I don't have to listen to this garbage. Besides, I'm not talking to you.
It was nice running into you too, Vicky.
Told you, didn't she?
Only for a little while. I wanted to believe that you had finally come to me, Marley. I waited so long for that phone call from you. To hear that you had been thinking about France, about us.
That's what she said when she called?
She asked me to meet her on the docks. She said she was confused. She needed to talk.
She's really good, isn't she? What'd she say?
Vicky has decided that the only reason I'm attracted to you is because you look like her. She thinks I'm in love with her.
Are you?
No, I am not. That was over a long time ago.
Are you sure?
Marley, I am sure. Look, I have to go or I'll miss my flight. Are you all right?
Go ahead, I understand.
I don't want to leave things this way. I want you to believe me. What happens between us has nothing to do with Vicky. Mother, you're beautiful. But it's what's inside you that I can't forget.
There can't be anything between us, Jamie.
There can't be. And there is. That's the only thing that Vicky was right about. I'll call you when I get to St. Louis.
Hello.
It's me again.
It's late, Jake.
Look, Marley, I know you're angry, but I'm gonna make it up to you.
Not tonight.
Don't hang up. And I'm finally finishing this job up for Iris. By tomorrow, things will be back to normal. Just the two of us.
If you say so.
I do. It'll be like old times, only better, I promise.